начинаем. Да, okay, so we'll continue for our session. It's my pleasure to present Борис Волков, joint work with Special, talking about higher order traps in quantum control. Let's escape.
Good afternoon. First of all, I want to thank the organizers for the opportunity to speak on this conference. Can you see my slides?
Yes.
Oh, thank you very much. My talk is devoted to trapping behavior in quantum control escapes. I want to talk, my topic belongs to quantum control theory. On this slide, you can see some areas quantum control theory can found
recording in progress
some new applications. The origin of this theory came from the 80s, and on this reference you can find the big research paper devoted to the current situation in this theory. I want to talk about. I want to consider the closed quantum systems. So in my talk, I consider the Schrödinger equation with time-dependent Hamiltonian. Evolution of the system is described by as a solution of this Schrödinger equation. Here, H0 is a free Hamiltonian, and where is the interaction Hamiltonian? We consider them as Hermitian N times N matrices. And F is the Hockerring control. We consider it as an element of the space L2. We consider the problem, quantum control problem, with the fixed time t. So the typical quantum control problem can be formulated as the mere tip problem of the maximization of the some objective functional. And here you can find examples. You can find examples of the objective functionals. The first one is the transition probability from one state to another, poor state. The second one is the expectation of the system observable O. Here, rho zero is the initial state. It's a density matrix. And O is a system observable. So we consider the second objective functional. And the third one is a problem of the generation of the quantum gate. Quantum gate is, we can consider it as an element from the Lie group SU of N. And we want to generate evolution as close as possible as a quantum gate. The goal of my talk is talk about trap behavior of the possible trap behavior in the second problem for multi-level systems. And I want to talk about also I want to consider the third problem in the case of manipulation by one key qubit in the two level case. And in this case, the quantum problems really has not quantum concepts really has not traps. Optimal controls are points of global extremum of this objective function. Traps are controls which are local but not global extremum points of the objective functionals. And it is very important for numerical laboratory optimization to investigate can they have traps? Because if we have traps, it is better to use Gödel's search algorithms. But in the case when we have no traps, it is better to use local search algorithms. It was a conjecture by Rebus, Xie, and Rosenthal that there are no traps for in the quantum control code problems for any dimension, for any level. Their motivation was the following. Any objective partial can be described as a composition of the function f y on the E group and the evaluation mapping. And these functions, we consider as kinematic objective functions, have no points of local but not global extrema. It was several results. The first result was belongs to for Neumann. It is a physical naive construction because the fact that kinematic landscape has no traps implies only that regular controls are not traps. The control F is regular if the pressure differential of the evolution mapping at this control is surjective. Otherwise, it's called singular. Due to the chain rule, we have that regular controls are not traps in the case when the kinematical landscape has no traps. Not only real traps, the points of local not but not global extrema can complicate the work of the local search algorithms. For example, we can consider the second order trap. It is a critical control such that it is not a point of global extrema, but the Hessian, the second derivative of this objective threshold at this control, is semi-definitive at this control. And it was the first example by Pechin and Tenner that it is possible to construct the control class F with the second order trap. More in the paper by Defeke and Sophie Schimmer, some examples of real traps were constructed for multi-level quantum systems. I want to mention that any constant control is singular in the case when the then n is more or equal than 3, and there are non-constant single controls in the case when n is more or equal than 3. But it is an open problem. Can then be the traps? In all known examples of traps of the traps of some finite order are constant. And in my talk, examples will be also constant. I want to give another definition. It is a degeneration of the notion of the second order trap. For a given objective functional J, trap of nth order is a control which satisfies the following two conditions. F is not a point of global extremum of the objective function. Else, the Taylor expansion of the objective function at this control has the special form. It is a Taylor expansion. All my objective functions are analytical. You can see that it is a critical point because J runs from 2 to n, and the functional R satisfies the two conditions. First of all, R is not zero, and the restriction of R on any line through zero is less than is less and or equal than zero in some vicinity of zero. So it is possible to have a growth of objective partial and along some direction with order of growth n. But in all other directions, we have the fidelity of the object functions became less with less order. For example, if we have n, if n is zero, it means that the second derivative is semi-definitive. Control f zero is a trap of infinite order of the objective function if the following two conditions satisfies. It is my sprint. F no is not a point of global extrema of the objective function, and the restriction of this objective function on every line through zero has a local maxima at the point zero. We want to consider the special class of quantum systems. Let O and H0 commute. And also let the initial state be the Pooh state. It is a projection of the nth state. And we consider the problem expectation of a system observable. A quantum system is globally unitary controllable for time not greater than time minimum. Is any possible evolution can be generated for time no larger than time minimum. And we want to consider globally unitary controllable quantum systems. In this case, we fidelity of the objective function on any control can be found by this formula. And fidelity on the constant zero control is simply lambda n. It is the eigenvalues of the observable. And if our quantum system is controllable, state to case, state to state controllable, it is in all dimensional, it is less strict notion than it is more weak condition than unitary controllable. Then if lambda n is neither the largest one nor the smallest tangent value of the target observable, then control f0 is not a point of global extrema of the objective function. And of course, constant control is singular, and it's a critical point of the objective function. So we want to show that this can be the trap. We show that it is not a point of global extrema if lambda n is not largest nor and is not the smallest integer value. Let v t is a we can see the action of the value of the free evolution on the interaction Hamiltonian. And we consider the Taylor series for it is a Dyson series for evolution mapping. And we substitute this expression into objective functional. We want introduce some some forms of order n on the control space. It this form I n l k is defined as this integral functional. And note that a zero l k is the Kronecker delta. And it is useful. We can use it for description of the Taylor series. So the Taylor series of the objective functionals at the constant zero control can be found by this formula, using these forms. Using this formula. So we want to analyze this formula. We can construct the family of the chain of embedded infinite dimensional manifolds. Let H gotic H zero be the space L2, and H n plus one is introduced by induction. It is all controls which belongs H n, such that these forms are zero on this control if lambda L is less than lambda n. It is eigen values of the object of observable. So, for example, H1 is always finite co-dimensional subspace of L2. And it is our main theorem. Let for all natural n from 1 to n0, the following conditions on the matrix of the matrix elements of the interaction Hamiltonian holds. It is it looks maybe different, difficult, but it is a way to construct special control systems with the trap. So then for all n, if control belongs to the to the set H of n minus 1 minus H1, we have that this derivative is strictly less than zero. And for all controls F from H n, it is misprint Hn, we have that this derivative and this derivative are zero. So if F0 is not a point of global extremum of the objective functional, then F0 is a trap of order 2n0 plus 1. This theorem was previously proved for the case when n0 is 1 by Pitchinian tenor. And in this case, these conditions only means that if lambda L is more than lambda n, this element is zero. This matrix element is zero. So, for example, we can consider the three level system is lambda atom, and the free Hamiltonian is diagonal, and the interaction Hamiltonian has this form. And in this case, the second derivative is semi-definitive. H1 is a space, is this common co-dimensional subspace of L2. And the second derivative and the third derivative are zero on this subspace, but the fourth derivative maybe is more, can be positive. We can consider the n-level quantum system. Let H is degenerate only to energy levels. And where is the interaction Hamiltonian? It is chained. It is known, it is a result from this paper, that such a system is globally unitary controllable for some time, for time not greater than some time mind. It was proved for the real. Okay, but it is also true for complex, but for dimensional n is 4. And in this case, we have the following theorem. Let n is more or less than 3. Let O observable has this form such that L lambda 1 is bigger than lambda n, and lambda n is bigger than lambda n minus 1. Then for time t which is bigger than time n, the control F0 is a trap of the order 2n minus 3 for the objective function. Because we knew that this system is globally unitary controllable. It is used. Ну, in this case, all these manifolds are the same. H1 and H1 and minus 1 is still this codimensional subspace of the control space. And the second derivative is less than 2 for all f from which doesn't belong to this space, and all derivatives are from 2 of order n, where n runs from 2 to 1 to n minus 3 are 0. But this derivative is positive on this subspace, not negative on this subspace. Ну, moreover, we can consider ну more general situation when H1 diagonal. Here, mu core is defined as a Bohr. Ну, it is IHK minus IHK plus one. It is known that this system is controllable if m mu one is not zero and mu one square in the square in the power of two is not equal to mu q in the power of two. And in this case, we also have the following theorem. But we have more conditions on the observable. In this case, we need that lambda 1 is bigger than lambda, lambda n, and we need that lambda k is less than lambda n for all k, which runs from 2 to n minus 1. And also in this case, we have the trap of order 2n minus 3. And we can in the case when this chained in the succession of our chain of embedded manifold is zero, we have a trap of finite order. And we constructed the example of the quantum system when we have the trap of finite order. It is the five level system. But in the case when we want to manipulate by one qubit, when n is zero, there is only one single control, F0. It is defined by this formula. And it is possible to check that this only one single control is not a trap. Ну, is there some example, some results of Pechenny and Lin that for all three types of objective functionals, the constant singular control is not trap for large time. And in the case when we want to generate a quantum gate objective, quantum gate, there were two cases. The first case is when quantum gate doesn't commute with this Hamiltonian. And in this case, it was known that there are no traps. But if in the case when they commute, it was known only for large times. And recently we showed that for short times there are no traps. No, we can consider only a phase shift quantum gate. The general case can be reduced to this form. Here I have not many times as I see.
Yes, more or less you have to come to quick ends.
Okay. In this quick, no, we reduce to this case. We can reduce our problem to this case. And we can consider the spectrum of the spectrum of the Hessian at this control, and we showed have shown that there are some areas of the parameters of the our problem. In these areas, it is a saddle point, and this area it is a point of the global extrema. It is a short time, and we have not. And now our problem is not countable for this time, and we have our fidelity is less than one, but it is global extrema. It was shown numerically, but we have investigated our spectrum. Moreover, we have found all negatives and positive eigen values of the Hessian at this. Of the Hessian at this control, constant control, we could simplify our proof. So we can move some pictures of our problem in this area. We have global extrema. What in this area? It is global extrema. It is the best way to provide an exact GS. It is use constant control and wait this time. In our theory, it is the saddle point. So here I want to finish. We have introduced the way to construct the control scale for a strongly degenerate quantum control systems with the trap of order of the 2n-3. And we have shown combined analytical methods and numerical optimization methods that control scales or ultra fast generation of spaceship Siebel Cupid gates is free of traps. And we also have studied the detailed structure of control constraints for this problem. We have investigated the spectrum of Hessian at this control. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you very much. Any questions, please? No question. Everything. So what can you say about infinite level system? Is there anything about it, or just only finite?
Печень and Tenor has considered one dimensional there were, I know one work with infinite dimensional case. It was pitching in a tenor, and it was free of traps. It was both using to know it was difficult to speak on English about this, but there was one work.
So it's only almost no result. So if I give you just a normal Schrödinger equation in R3, say, with given potential multiplied by this function of t, and I'm asking whether there is a trap or not, and basically you cannot answer. Yeah?
Yes, of course, it is not. It is not. Well studied, I think. There was some conjectures. Some people want traps to absent, and but there are no strict proofs.
Maybe. Okay, so only numeric result, yeah. For the
yes, and the case of one qubit. In the case of one qubit, really there is the absence of traps, only in this case.
Oh yeah, of course, one qubit is something very simple.
Yes, of course. Only one single control, and we can check it. But in the many dimensional situation is not clear, and of course in the finite dimensional there are only one special work where in the special problem we've also no traps.
Okay. No other further questions or comments, please. No? Okay, then let's thank again the speaker for a very nice presentation.